The Sprite Editor is used to take images containing multiple elements, like an atlas or sprite sheet, and slice them into individual sprites. It is important that the sprite mode of the image is set to multiple. Images with sprite mode set to single cannot use the Sprite Editor window at this time. For more information on sprites, sprite mode, and the sprite type, please see the information link below. When Sprite Mode Multiple is selected, the Sprite Editor button will appear on the texture importer in the inspector. Click the Sprite Editor button to open the Sprite Editor. The Sprite Editor can also be opened by selecting Window, Sprite Editor. The Sprite Editor window is a standard Unity window. It can be used and docked like any other window. To create sprites in the Sprite Editor window, slice the image by clicking and dragging over the desired elements. This will create rectangular selections that define each sprite. The rectangular selection can be adjusted by clicking and dragging the rectangle. Click and drag anywhere inside the rectangle to move it. Click and drag any of the corners or edges to resize it. Click and drag the pivot point gizmo to move the pivot point for that sprite. When a sprite is selected, a sprite panel appears in the lower right of the Sprite Editor with details about the selected sprite. Name is the name of the sprite. The name is created from the name of the original image and the order in which it was sliced from that image, starting with 0. Position defines where the sprite is on the image in pixels. X and Y define the start point of the sprite, measured from the lower left corner of the image to the lower left corner of the sprite. W and H define the width and height of the sprite from the start point. The trim button can be used to trim off any excess space around the element, creating the tightest fitting rectangle possible. Pivot sets the pivot point for this sprite. The pivot drop-down menu includes presets for each corner and the center of each edge. Custom allows for a custom pivot point to be set numerically under Custom Pivot. Along the top of the Sprite Editor are a number of tools. The Slice menu, the Revert and Apply buttons, the RGB Alpha toggle, and the Zoom slider. The Slice menu is used to automatically create sprites by slicing the sprite elements from the image. The slice type is either automatic or grid. Automatic is best for slicing individual uneven elements, like from an atlas. Elements on the image are automatically detected based on the empty space around them. Each sprite will have effectively been trimmed as a result. With Automatic selected, Minimum Size defines the minimum size for each individual sprite. If this value is set too high, smaller elements that are near each other could be combined into one larger sprite to meet the minimum size requirements. Pivot sets the default pivot point that will be applied to all sprites when they are sliced from the image. Just like the Sprite panel, the Pivot drop-down menu includes presets for each corner and the center of each edge. To set a custom pivot, once the sprites have been sliced, select any sprite and adjust its pivot point in the Sprite panel, or adjust it visually in the editor. Method lets you choose how to deal with existing sprites in the Sprite Editor window. Delete Existing will replace any sprites that already exist with new sprites. Smart will attempt to create new sprites while retaining and adjusting existing ones. Safe will add new sprites without changing any sprites already created. When the settings are correct, select the Slice button to slice the image into individual sprites. After slicing, each sprite can be edited individually. With the Sprite Sheet, where each element is designed to be a regular, identical size, if Slice Type Automatic is used, small changes in the individual sprite's shape and the amount of empty space surrounding it could cause the sprites to be cut out unevenly. To evenly slice a sprite sheet made of regular elements, choose Slice Type Grid. Pixel Size sets the size of the grid in pixels. Pivot sets the default pivot point that will be applied to all sprites when they are sliced from the image. To set a custom pivot, once the sprites have been sliced, select any sprite and adjust its pivot point in the sprite panel or adjust it visually in the editor. When the settings are correct, use the Slice button to slice the image into individual sprites. After slicing, each sprite can be edited individually. When slicing is complete, to save any changes, select Apply, or discard any changes by selecting Revert. The RGB alpha toggle switches the display of the sprite editor between the color image and its alpha channel, making it easier to see fine details when manually adjusting edges. The zoom slider controls the zoom when viewing the image. When an image has been successfully edited and the changes applied, the asset will update in the project window, and a new sprite or set of sprites can be seen as a child or group of children under the image. When viewing thumbnails in the project view, click the turndown arrow to see any children. Each child represents a usable sprite from that image. Any of these sprites can be used in the project independently, or grouped together to create a character, for example, or used sequentially as animations.